When I was around 7 years old, I shared a room with my uncle who was going to film school at the time. One late night, I walked in and he was watching a scene from Gummo. I was completely confused, but taken by the imagery and atmosphere of the film. I didn't know what to think. My uncle's email for years was Gummo and Me, and we had the VHS in our room until he lent it to a friend who never returned it. So I had watched it once as a kid, and I always remembered parts of it, but when I was in 9th grade, it was playing on the IFC channel, and I watched it again. I remember being like, huh? I don't know if I like this or not. But I told my friends about it, and they had to watch it, so I bought a copy of it. It was pretty expensive, too. I remember while watching the neo-Nazi brothers fist fight in their kitchen thinking, this is legit. They're actually fighting. You can't actually fight in a movie. Then I thought, movies are about doing whatever you want. Fuck rules and fuck restrictions. That's when I realized I love Gummo. I usually start my videos with a spoiler warning, but this film doesn't really have a story. It's like a dream. We just drift into the movie, and an hour and a half later, it ends. Harmony Korine, the director, said films need a beginning, middle, and an end, but it doesn't have to be in that order. Let's be honest. Harmony has said a lot of things about this film, but he was high when he said them, and he was high when he made this film. Harmony wrote the screenplay for kids when he was 18, which was a giant success, and this got him the money to make Gummo. Like a lot of people at that age, this was the time in his life when he was using drugs, getting fucked up, and having fun. But he was also a famous artist who was making films, painting, and writing books during that time. Some of the art he made was great, and some wasn't. I personally think this is one of his best achievements. Harmony Korine filmed Gummo in his hometown in Tennessee, but in the film, the town is called Xenia, Ohio. This film opens up with an explanation of the town. It tells you that a tornado hit it years ago and several people died, and the city has never been the same since. That's the closest thing to a plot this film has. The rest of the film is basically a few days in the life of strange people who live in this town. There's Tumblr and Solomon. They kill cats with their BB guns and sell the meat to grocery stores and use the money for glue to huff and get high from. There's a kid named Jared Wiggly who also kills cats, so they break into his house and kill his grandma. They also find out he's been like making gay porn with him being the subject. They also pay a man to have sex with his mentally retarded sister. There's another handicapped woman who shaves her eyebrows, and there's a gay midget and a drunk Harmony Korine. Solomon eats spaghetti and chocolate in a bathtub when the water is almost black. There's Dot and her two sisters, they lose their cat, they put up some flyers around town, and they get picked up by a pervert, but they get away from him.
What are you doing?
Then there's a random kid with tattoos on his fingers who skates and is dressed up like a bunny. At the end, we see him making out with Dot and her sister inside an above-ground swimming pool as it rains hard. The end is just some random obese people singing about Jesus, then it cuts to some satanic imagery and ends with a black metal song. This movie is basically just random sequences put together, but I love most of them. Some are funny, some are scary, and some are sad, but they all feel real, ugly, and sometimes beautiful. I look at this film as a beautiful disaster. If this film was a dream, it would be a nightmare. But even in my nightmares, there's moments of beauty that I can't help but appreciate. So many people look at this film with disgust. They feel sorry for these people, but don't ever want to be around them. I can't blame them for not wanting to be around this. I don't think Harmony was trying to scare anyone with these people or locations. These are people he grew up with. This was his childhood. It's filmed in Tennessee, but places like this exist everywhere. To me, it represents the ghetto or crack houses. There's moments of this film that take me right back to my childhood. Like when Tumblr and Solomon are getting high with that girl in her house, and her little brother is just there chilling. He tries to fix a picture frame, and all these roaches appear, and he just puts it back. That moment stands out to me so much. I've been that kid. I've been to houses like that, and it wasn't fun, but it was part of my childhood, and even though it was scary, I still have nostalgic feelings for those memories. This film feels like you're going through a family picture album put together by someone who went through a mental breakdown. This film kind of reminds me of the television show Cops. All of a sudden, you're in these people's houses and lives. There's only a few legit actors in this film. Everyone else are random people Harmony found at bowling alleys and Burger Kings. A few of them are people he went to high school with. There's just an honest, but at the same time otherworld-like feeling to this film. Harmony is like an alien. No one thinks or makes art like he does. This film represents a time in his youth and career where he was even more crazy than usual. I feel like this film is the subconscious of an artist under the influence of just the right amount of drugs. This film is pure art. He created these insane visuals from his mind and brought them to life. Even if I hated this film, I know that I would have to respect that. As much as I love this film, I totally understand why others would hate it. But to me, the biggest sin a film can commit is to be unmemorable. How many average, boring movies do you watch, and by the next year, you can't even remember what happened in them? No matter how you feel about this film, you're never going to forget it. Harmony burns these images into your brain. He takes you to this world, and for an hour and a half, you can't help but be sucked into it. I don't even consider this a review. I'm sure people don't even consider this a movie. I just wanted to talk about this film for a bit. So thanks for watching, keep watching, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, hit that like button, and follow me on Instagram, cinemajunkies_. Don't forget the underscore.